Hampton, February 14th, 1869. Mrs. Samuel Reed Hall and ladies of the sewing circle. Respected friends, your kind letter dated January 29th, advising us of your intention to send to our care a box for the freedmen, was delayed some days by the storm, and the box did not reach us until this week, Monday. We thank you for enabling us to relieve so many. There has been a great deal of suffering in this section during the very severe weather, both for clothes and food. We have been unable to help many. By their friends in Vermont having just at the right time sent us five boxes, many of the very worthy ones who were taking care of themselves have been obliged to take down their huts and move during this cold time, because their lots had been returned to their former owners, by this subjecting them to extra expense they were not able to bear, and obliging some to ask for aid who otherwise would not. In a village near us called Slabtown are two teachers, Mrs. Perrow and Mrs. Clark, who have been the teachers and advisors of that people for 3 years. They have truly been instant in season and out, and made themselves acquainted with their wants and woes. To them, Doctor went on receipt of the boxes and requested them to send the very destitute to us. We have been enabled to make happy many hearts. It is exceedingly difficult to know who to give to. Slavery has made the most of them deceitful, but we hope that in time they will be enabled to settle down on lands of their own and become not only law-abiding citizens, but earnest Christians, and with their friends at the North be enabled to help spread abroad the knowledge of Jesus. Mr. and Mrs. Stone are still held in grateful remembrance by this people, and well they may be, for they were truly their friends, and spared not themselves in labors of love. My own health has been very poor this winter, and have not been able to visit amongst them as I did last year. But every day the most of my time is occupied attending to their wants. We are not able to do much ourselves, and are thankful to those friends who make us their almoners. We try to discharge the trust faithfully. Very respectfully, your friends, Lucy A. Seymour.
Ellen Altarn. Mary Addison. Eliza Abbott. Anna Austin. Mary Baldwin. Sarah Baldwin. Mary S. Baldwin. Clara Benham. Narcissa Buxton. Lucina Bennett. Mary Brackett. Ellen Baxter. Emmeline Bannister, Carrie Bard, Ruth Barker, Adeliza Barnard, Esther, Sarah, and Eunice Gilbert, Julia Ann Gilman, Helen Groh, Anna Groh, Celia Going, Isabella Gates, Wait, Mary Hughes, Mary Huntoon, Almira and Roxy A. Huntoon too, Emily Hall, Harriet Hovey and Helen Hovey, Nancy Hanson and Head, Elmira Head, Kara Lahoy, Madania Homan and Lucretia Harmon and Josephine Harris, and Angelina Loveland, C.E.D. Levitt, Ruth Livingston and Emily LeBannister, Mary Miller, Azuba Manson and Lodas Camaro, Mary A. Miles and Louisa McGaffrey. Take a second to breathe. Emily Mead and Merchant, Mary E. Miles and Mary J. Merrick, Elizabeth Mussey, McCurdy McLaughlin, Julia Ann and Sabra Merriam, Angelica Miriam, Helen Nye, no Bill, but Millicent Orcutt, Martha Ordway, and four named Parker, Marcia, Lydia, Nancy, and Jane, Bring the Pains, Marion and Louisa, Lydia Pearson, Zellen Pierce, Eliza L. Priest, Charlotte Powers, Ellen Patton, Eliza Paddleford, Abby Ethelinda, Josephine and Mary Smith, Eliza Salisbury, Anne Spaulding, Susan Stearns, Hattie Stewart, Persa Stewart, Martha Stewart, Hannah and Susan Twombly, Stella and Mary Jane Thrasher, Jane Thurston, Anna Tarbell, Martha Walker, Louisa Walker, Sarah Wallace, Caroline Wiggins, Emily Ward, Marriott West, Sophia West, Charlotte Ware, Mary Jane Whippy, Susan White, Betsy White, Mary Ann Wright, Ellen Wright, Laura White, Caroline Wilder, Lucy Worthington, Persis Wheeler, Elvira Whitcomb, Emily Woolley, Elizabeth Wilcox, and lastly, J.K. Wolcott. And that's all.
In reverie let me wander, through dreamland wander o'er. Again the scenes of girlhood, in happy days of yore. Lead me through its ancient halls, and up the stairways dim. All good and true, who roam in pale days, doth sweetest memory hold. So many pleasing treasures, more precious far than gold. Their voices greet me, while loved ones linger near. And many a fervent hand clasp bespeaks that I am dear. The companionship of men, listen, 'tis the pealing, lo, of yonder silvery bell, like music stealing o'er me with sweet and thrilling. Doth our loved preceptor, with words most fitly spoke, the richest of all blessings on each one there invoke. Our joyful hearts united. Though long years have passed away, I seem to hear his voice, in earnest accents saying, my heaven, your early choice. His weary life is ended, his toilsome work is o'er, but we hope again to greet him on the celestial shore. Lead me through. The cross he bore has vanished, a glorious crown is won, with many a star bedecked, the gifts of God's dear Son.